All right, welcome back to what could possibly be the finale of this series. Now, on my way back up here, Meru did get hit with D-Spirit, but that's going to be fine. Once we use her healing ability, that'll be cured. More importantly, though, Meru's Perky Step got mastered. It's got a whopping 600% damage modifier. On the way up here, she ended up hitting 1,400 damage on one of the enemies. She's actually a pretty good character now. It took a lot of investment, but she's there. Now, Meru, we took away the dancer's shoes and gave her the attack badge. She's a little slower now, but she's doing more damage overall. We gave Albert the Giganto ring. I didn't want to give him the attack badge because he doesn't ever use magic attacks, so just giving him attack and physical defense, it's good enough. And now Dart. Dart has the Soul Eater, which drains 10% of his health every turn, and to offset that, we had the Therapy Ring. However, we're going to give him the attack badge. We're going to lean into that health drain. For the last fight, or the last couple fights, I'm going to be okay. We're going to let Dart's health drain. What could possibly go wrong? Oh, this isn't the last fight. It's more dungeon. Oops. I thought that was the end. Maybe it is. There's Shauna, okay. There's Zeke. He knocks the red dragon spirit out of our possession. Dart really needs to figure out a better way to hold on to his dragon spirit. That's twice in this game it's been taken from us. Here is our fight with the Red Dragoon Zeeg. Dart is unable to transform in this fight, unfortunately. Let's start off with, hopefully, a perky step. Perky. 1,200 damage off of Meru, of all people. She's finally... She's grown up so fast, guys. I'm so proud. Flame shot. Now, Dart is immune to all fire damage with the Red Dragoon armor, so that's nice for us. Not quite. Even a failure is still 500 damage. If he just keeps doing magic on Dart, it's not gonna do anything. So, I don't see a reason for us to transform into dragoons here. Reason to heal. We also got the we got her rank 5 dragoon level as well, so she could summon her dragoon. Dragon, which I might. I'll summon a dragon. I'm really surprised that they didn't just reuse the water dragon boss we fought a couple times. They actually gave Meru her own dragon. Dart and Zeke clash swords, but Shauna has already begun to merge. And we finally see the truth. Melbu Frama, the old Wingly Emperor. Zeke impaled him on his sword, and during that cutscene, Melbu Frama said something about cursing Zeke. And we saw him get petrified, but the truth is that the petrification was only a side effect. Melbu Frama's spirit possessed Zeke, and has been possessing him this entire time. So it seems like the story is Zeke was cured to petrification somehow, and he was still himself at that time. He met Claire and married Claire, and they had Dart together. But when Rose attacked as the black monster to kill the Moonchild, Zeke attempted to call upon the dragon spirit to become the Red Dragoon, but at that moment, Melbu Frama's spirit overtook him. And his ultimate goal is to let Shauna merge with the moon that never sets, birth the 108th entity. Well, no, it seems like he doesn't need Shauna. Seems like he, instead of Shauna merging, he's going to merge himself, and he's going to become the 108th entity. Here is Lloyd. After a long time, he's back. Still wants to create a utopia. Like, he was kind of an anti-hero the entire time, but Melbu Frama manipulated him, and now he's come to stop Melbu Frama. But he fails. But Lloyd did do something. He brought with him the Divine Dragon Spirit. The one he took out of the corpse of the Divine Dragon long ago. And it resonates with Dart. Dragon Buster is also Rose's final weapon. Unfortunately, it does not go to Dart. Brings her attack plus 60 attack from her next highest weapon. Anyway. I'm going to attempt to run away. May I run away, please? Need to go save. There doesn't appear to be random battles here. We are fully healed. If you see on the right, with all the our dragon spirits, we now are missing the red spirit, but we have the divine spirit. And for this last battle alone, we can make use of it. Alright, the reason I say it is because all of those graphical glitches we've experienced up until that point. I don't know how the final boss battle's gonna go. I'm a little worried. How's Shauna doing? Ashel? Grandpa? It's nice that Melbu Frama is just chilling back there, waiting for us to get our dialogue out of the way. Kongol is actually super wise. He just doesn't speak well. Jeez, it's a lot of tentacles. Well, let's get rid of them. These attack items. Let's use them. Ow. And we missed, but who cares? Not yet. Not yet. It's a bit early to use these, but we'll do it. It's time. Darch has become a big beefy boy. Damage.
Rosestorm.
I'm planning to use a party-wide MP heal after this transformation ends, so I'm just gonna throw everything we have at this guy. I don't know what that did. But here's another Divine Dragon Cannon. We've got plenty of healing items, I feel like, so we're just going to use our magic. Freezing, 600 damage ain't nothing. Like all good boss fights, there's a phase two. And this boss fight sort of goes through the entire history of the planet and the universe, starting with its creation here, where everything was simple and not very orderly, kind of ugly. Unfortunately, the scene transition sort of canceled out Dart's aura, because he's the one who started the whole party transformation. He should have gotten an automatic addition, but since the background changed as part of the scene transition, I don't get that anymore. Alright. So Meru has been removed from my party. Temporarily. Thank you. Okay. Nice! Yes! I get for getting too excited. I was hoping we could get Meru out by now so Albert could do another Rose Storm before his transformation ends, but I don't know. Meru's still in there, and I can't target anything else, so the only thing I can do is keep attacking. I respect it. I didn't want to be transformed anyway. It's fine. I need a full heal. And I need a full MP heal. Now we move on. The next phase of creation. Instead of in space, we're now on a very barren wasteland. The next phase. Water is introduced to Earth. The land masses shift, create continents. He just chewed me.
Blossom Storm.
I'd like to try to do another party-wide transformation again, so I gotta build everyone back up.
Blazing Dynamo!
Oh no, not the galaxy beam! I don't like these things. Well, that was not. Oh, God! Please don't do it a third time. Fuck you. Oh, thank God Mary was not dead. Oh, now she is. Oh. Alright. You know what I'm feeling? Feeling another full heal. That is dangerously close. Not yet. Not yet. Ooh. Oh, it's daytime. I wanted to wait for the phase transition. See, now water introduces life to the void planet. This must be such a trip. If you've never seen this game before, it makes no sense. Life brings civilization. And it's not always happy civilization. Life brings death. With the boss powered down, both his offense and defense have decreased. So just like our powered up dart, now everyone's gonna be able to do a bit more damage to the boss. Let's give it the old Divine Dragon Cannon. Let's just bust out all the dragon stuff. You know, in this fight, the accessory that doubles a character's MP would be really good for Dart. Like, his Divine Dragon Cannon only costs 50 MP, so raising his maximum MP to 200 would allow him to do it four times, which would be insane. You know, let's throw Albert's dragon out there. It's just dragons all day long. This one's probably not going to do a whole lot of damage, but hey, why not? About as much as his physical attacks. I think we're immune to status ailments here that, as long as they aren't instant death, I think we're immune to them. Yeah. Unfortunate. You know what's not unfortunate? A divine dragon cannon to the face! I can remember a playthrough I did as a kid where I think I had a Game Shark for the original PlayStation, and you were able to play the game from the start with a Divine Dragon Spirit. And that was insane. Okay. I assume that's like a pure defensive barrier. Where he's absorbing the knowledge of all life on the planet. Some fucking shit. I don't know. Oh. That was a dragon block staff. Yeah, okay, so we're not gonna have a good time here. Ah, we can't even... I wish there was a way to cancel out of a transformation. Because now I just gotta wait for it to end. There's nothing really I can do. Meru, at least, is back to regular strength. Ow! It's almost worth it to let everyone die. Because then I could just revive them and they would be out of Dragoon form. But that's risky. I could do Rose Storm. I'm okay with you attacking Meru. She doesn't die in one hit. Alrighty. I mean, this is no Divine Dragon Cannon, but it's doing its work right here. Alright, now Dart is back to regular strength. Late, but fine. At least Albert is able to get one final attack off. I need to heal Dart. I should consider that. At some point.
Blazing Dynamo!
Oh! I think we won the video games! You know what, I'm not going to say no to a free Divine Dragon Cannon. I'm just going to sit back and watch in all its glory. Man, the Divine Dragon armor is like a mech.
I have been waiting for this moment.
I kept you waiting so long. I'm sorry.
Arr! Arr!
outside me. A god. Rose. The time has come. This is the end of our long journey.
Zeke.
Could you come with me?
Yes. I will never leave you again.
So Rose and Zeke stay behind, giving their lives to make sure Melbu Frama stays dead. Thus the world is left to those who belong in it, the belong in this timeline. Alright. That was Legend of Dragoon. It's a damn good game. The FMV cutscenes had terrible voice acting, but that's okay. I have only a few nitpicks about the game. I think instant death attacks in every game are still bad. I'd like to see a sequel to this game with, like, the Mario RPG-style defending mechanic where you actually have a button pressed to mitigate some damage. What's interesting is that they never actually addressed it, but Shauna is actually the princess to this kingdom. It was her twin sister, the princess, that Rose killed, mistaking to be the Moon Child, but Shauna survived. Notice that only Lisa is here, and Emil is gone. There's Meru and her fiancé. Oh, and we have other races. I think that was Minininios. We have the wedding of Albert and Emil. So Dart returns to Cells to help rebuild. And of course, Shauna comes with. Everyone lived unhappily ever after because there's no Legend of Dragoon 2. Unfortunate. Is that the end? Was that all the credits? Is it one of those games where there's just a blank screen? Or did I freeze? Well, if I froze, I don't care, because we're done. Thanks for joining us. I really enjoyed this game. It's been like 20 years, and I'm really happy I got to replay it. I don't know what I'm going to do next, but I'll see you.